In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of rhomboid. Rhomboid is this muscle. Actually, you can divide rhomboid to two parts. This part and this part. The blue part is rhomboid minor. Yellow one is rhomboid major. Okay, I'm going to explain their origin, insertion, function, and important myofascial connection. Let me talk about origin of rhomboid minor. That is from cervical spines, particularly C6 through C7. C6 through C7. This is about this area. This is origin of rhomboid minor. Okay, then insertion is right here. This part is medial border. Medial border. Some anatomy books say medial border above spine of scapula. Spine of scapula is here. See, rhomboid minor attaches to medial border a little bit above spine of scapula. Again, this is rhomboid minor. Some fibers of rhomboid minor attaches to above spine of scapula. This is it. This is origin and insertion of rhomboid minor. Let's go to rhomboid major. Origin is here. These are thoracic spines. This fiber is from T1 through T4. T1 through T4. Basically, rhomboid minor attaches to cervical spines. Rhomboid major attaches to thoracic spines. This is important to distinguish. Where is insertion? Insertion is same as rhomboid minor. This is it. This is medial border. Particularly below spine of scapula. Again, rhomboid minor is above spine of scapula. Rhomboid major is below spine of scapula. This is origin and insertion of rhomboid. Let me explain their function. Alright, functions of rhomboid minor and rhomboid major are same. Thus, I will not separate function of these two muscles. I will treat these two muscles as one muscle in this section. Okay, main function of rhomboid is scapular adduction. That is scapular adduction. It is not shoulder adduction. Shoulder adduction is you cross arm like this way, right? This is shoulder adduction. Scapula is this way. You bring scapula towards thoracic spine. This is scapular adduction. Both rhomboid minor and rhomboid major do scapular adduction. This is one function. There's one more function. That is this kind of movement. This is downward rotation. Downward rotation is like inferior angle of scapula faces this way. This is downward rotation. By the way, the other movement, the other direction is called upward rotation. This is important. I will explain this movement later. Anyhow, functions of rhomboid is scapular adduction and downward rotation, plus one more important function. It is not movement, but it's important thing. That is stabilization. Stabilization of scapula, stability of scapula. It is important to control movement of scapula. Why is that? Because if your scapula is unstable, if it's kind of sluggy, if it's sluggish movement, you can't control your shoulder joint very properly. That is why movement and stability of scapula is important for shoulder movement. Anyhow, these are functions of rhomboid, scapular adduction, downward rotation, plus stabilization, stability. Now let me explain important myofascial connection. Alright, myofascial connection with rhomboid. Again, this is rhomboid. Then I want to focus on these muscles. This is neck muscle. This part is splenius capitis. And this part is splenius services. Splenius capitis and splenius services. If you think about direction, orientation of rhomboid, it's kind of going this way, right? It's going to diagonal. This is right side rhomboid. This is left side. And if you think about direction of splenius muscles, they are also diagonal. It's like going this way. Thus, right side rhomboid and left side splenius muscles kind of match together, right? Thus, if right side rhomboid gets tight, maybe left side splenius muscles can get tight. What happens if splenius muscles get tight? That can lead to tight neck, neck pain, or headache. Why is that? Because splenius services attaches to cervical spines. Because services indicates cervical spines. Splenius capitis goes to head. Because capitis indicates head. Correct? Again, tight rhomboid may affect for the other side splenius muscles. Vice versa, if left side rhomboid gets tight, that may affect for right side splenius muscles. Is that clear? This is very important relationship. What is function of rhomboid? That is movement and stability of scapula. Thus, the other side splenius muscle tightness may affect for this side scapula movement and function. By the way, this myofascial connection theory is from a book called Anatomy Trains. This is very kind of basic, very interesting book to see myofascial connection in human body. This is rhomboid and splenius muscles connection. Let me explain one more connection. Okay, this is a little bit from lateral view. This is rhomboid again. Then I want to focus on this muscle. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior, that attaches to anterior surface of scapula, like this. It's very close to medial border, anterior part of medial border. Yep, medial border. The other muscle attaches to medial border, correct? What is that? That's rhomboid, right here. Rhomboid and serratus anterior are very close each other, like that. Plus, what is function of serratus anterior? Number one is scapular abduction. Scapular abduction. One more function is upward rotation. Wait a minute. What are functions of rhomboid? That is scapular adduction. Adduction plus downward rotation, right? Oh my gosh, functions of rhomboid and serratus anterior are completely opposite. Thus, if rhomboid is tight, movement of serratus anterior may be restricted. Vice versa, if serratus anterior doesn't move or serratus anterior is tight, rhomboid may not move because of this kind of a opposite movement relationship, right? Thus, these two muscles are kind of crucial for scapular movement. If these muscles get tight, scapula may not move properly. This is a big issue for shoulder. Why is that? Do you remember? I said, when your scapula does not move, or when your scapula is not very well stabilized, shoulder is hard to move. Because when you move shoulder, your scapula needs to move together. This relationship is freaking important for upper extremity movement. That is why adequate tension of rhomboid plus serratus anterior is crucial for shoulder movement. I love this myofascial connection, particularly rhomboid serratus balance. I hope this kind of myofascial connection help your career, help your understanding of human body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.